Today's story is called Favorite Son. The memory verse is from John chapter 15, verse 12. It says, "Love each other as I have loved you." Today's message is God helps me love my Christian family. Is there anything that you really wish you had? Have you ever wanted it so badly that it made you angry because someone else had it and you didn't? 10 boys wanted what their brother had. They were so jealous of him that they planned something terrible. Joseph had 11 brothers, 10 older brothers, and 1 younger brother. The older brothers did not like him at all. They probably left him out of the games they played. They didn't take him with them when they went somewhere. They didn't want to be around him. The Bible says they hated him. Joseph was Father Jacob's favorite son. Their father always gave him the best presents. When Father Jacob made Joseph a colorful new coat, all the brothers were jealous. They didn't think Joseph deserved nicer things than they got. Joseph's brothers also thought he was proud, which made them even angrier. Once God gave Joseph a dream that he and his brothers had been cutting stalks of grain and tying them into sheaves. Suddenly, all of his brothers' sheaves bowed to his. Another time, he dreamed that the sun, moon, and 11 stars had bowed down to him. Father Jacob asked, "Does this mean that you will rule over your mother and me someday?" They enjoyed being out on their own with no little brother to annoy them. But one day, Father Jacob asked Joseph to find them and to see how they were. Joseph, wearing his bright new coat, went in search of his brothers. And they saw him coming. "Here comes the dreamer," they said. "Let's kill him and throw his body into a well." They were all alone with the sheep. No one would know what they had done. The oldest brother, Reuben, disagreed. "Don't kill him," he argued. "Let's not shed any blood. Throw him into this dry well, but don't hurt him." Reuben knew that Joseph wouldn't be able to get out. The brothers could scare Joseph by leaving him in the well. Reuben didn't want to kill Joseph. He secretly planned to take Joseph out of the well later. Then he would take him back to their father. So when Joseph arrived, what a shock was waiting. His brothers didn't welcome him. They grabbed him and threw him into the well. Then Reuben left for a while. Before Reuben returned, a caravan of traders passed by, and the 9 brothers sold Joseph to them. He would become a slave. When Reuben returned, he looked for Joseph in the well, but didn't find him. He tore his clothes to show how upset he was and went to his brothers. "The boy is gone! What shall I do?" he cried. So the brothers killed a goat and soaked Joseph's beautiful coat in its blood. They would tell their father that Joseph had been killed by a wild animal. Joseph was actually on his way to Egypt. He would be far away from his father, his brothers, and his lovely coat. What would become of him? Jesus asks us to love our brothers and sisters. He says this for a reason. Our families fall apart when we don't love one another. Jesus doesn't want our family, the church, to fall apart. He will help you love your home and your church family. Ask Him to help you be loving. Today's story is called Don't Let Go. The memory verse is from Revelation chapter 3, verse 11. It says, "Hold on to what you have so that no one will take your crown." Today's message is when I obey God, I make the right choices in my community. Can you remember the last time someone wanted you to do something that you knew was wrong? What did you do? Did you remember what you had been taught at home or at church about living for Jesus? Did that help you make the right choice? Joseph remembered that his family's God was with him and would help him. Let's read about it. When Joseph was sold by his brothers, he might have been tempted to give up on God. He might have thought that God should not have let him be sent far away. But then his thoughts turned to his home and what his father had taught him about God. He had told Joseph that God always keeps his promises. Joseph decided to always obey God. In return, God blessed him. The Bible says the Lord was with Joseph. When Joseph was sold to a man named Potiphar, God was with him and blessed Potiphar too. Soon Potiphar gave Joseph responsibility for his entire house. God blessed Joseph and many people liked him. Potiphar's wife noticed what a good job Joseph did. She also saw that he was very handsome. Satan used her to tempt Joseph. One day, Potiphar's wife asked Joseph to do something he knew was wrong. Since Joseph had decided to obey God, he said no. Actually, he said more than that. He said, "How can I sin against God?" Joseph knew that doing what this woman asked him to do would be wrong, and it would be a sin, and it would make God sad. But Potiphar's wife didn't give up. Every day she asked Joseph to come to her, and each day he refused. When she realized Joseph wasn't going to do what she wanted, she decided to get Joseph into trouble. "I want to be alone with you," she told Joseph. Again, Joseph said no. As he turned to go, she grabbed his coat, pulling it off. "Help!" she called to the other servants. "Joseph tried to attack me." It wasn't true. Joseph had been faithful to God and loyal to his master Potiphar. But Potiphar's wife showed him Joseph's coat. She told Potiphar that Joseph had attacked her and left his coat behind. So Potiphar sent Joseph to prison. Poor Joseph! He had lost his job even though he had done nothing wrong. Yet even though Joseph was in prison, he knew that God was still with him. He believed that God would continue to bless him. God wants to be with you, too. When He is with you, it is much easier to live for Jesus. It is easier to say no to Satan. Joseph learned about God from his family. He probably decided to trust and obey God from seeing some of the mistakes his father had made. When you decide to obey God, you will make the right choices in your home and in your community and wherever you go. And you don't have to worry about what will happen to you. Today's story is called Free at Last. The memory verse is from Matthew chapter 25, verse 23. It says, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things." Today's message is God helps me to be faithful no matter what happens. Have you ever had a dream that you couldn't remember? Or have you had a dream that didn't make sense? Today's story is about dreams that left someone very puzzled. Potiphar put Joseph in prison after Potiphar's wife accused Joseph of a crime. God knew that Joseph was innocent. He let Joseph go to prison anyway. Sometimes God lets his people be put in the strangest places for a special reason. God blessed Joseph even in prison. The prison warden noticed the good work that Joseph did. He soon put him in charge of the other prisoners. Pharaoh's cupbearer and baker were two of the men Joseph met in prison. One day, Joseph noticed that these men were sad. They both had just dreamed a dream they could not understand. Joseph knew about dreams. God had given him some important dreams when he was younger. He listened to the men's stories, and God helped him to tell them the meanings of their dreams. Everything he said would happen did happen. The cupbearer returned to work for the king, but the baker did not. Joseph had asked the cupbearer to mention him to Pharaoh in hopes of getting him out of prison. But the cupbearer forgot all about Joseph, and Joseph spent 2 more years in prison after that. One night, Pharaoh had 2 dreams. In the first dream, he saw 7 fat cows eating grass on the riverbank. Then, out of nowhere, came 7 skinny cows and ate them up. In a second dream, Pharaoh saw 7 ears of healthy corn, and then suddenly 7 little unhealthy ears of corn appeared and swallowed up the healthy ones. These dreams disturbed Pharaoh so much that he couldn't go back to sleep. What did they mean? No one in Pharaoh's palace could understand the dreams. Then the king's cupbearer remembered Joseph, and Joseph was brought from prison. Joseph told Pharaoh that God sometimes gives people dreams. He had given these dreams to Pharaoh for a reason, and God had given Joseph the meaning of them. "Your 2 dreams predict the same event," Joseph explained. "For the next 7 years, Egypt will grow more food than you could possibly use. The cows and the grain will be fat. Then the 7 years after that will be very bad. No food will grow, and many people could starve. You should build more storehouses. Keep the extra grain grown in the fat years," Joseph suggested. "If you do, Egypt will have enough food for the years of famine." Pharaoh agreed with Joseph. He decided that Joseph was a wise man, so he set him in charge of building the storehouses. Pharaoh gave Joseph his official ring. He gave him nice clothes, nicer than those taken by his brothers or by Potiphar's wife. And he placed Joseph in charge of the entire country of Egypt. Truly, the Lord was with Joseph. He left Joseph in prison for a reason. When bad things happen to us, we can be faithful like Joseph. God can help us be faithful to Him, the God we are learning about in our home and church families. He can do great things with our lives, no matter where we go or what happens. Today's story is called Finally Forgiven. The memory verse is from Luke chapter 6, verse 37. It says, "Forgive, and you will be forgiven." Today's message is God helps me to forgive others. Has anyone you love ever done something that has caused you pain or hurt your feelings? Sari stole from her best friend Misha and then lied about it. She thought no one would ever know. But Sari was caught, and Misha and her family felt very hurt and betrayed. Years later, Sari asked for forgiveness, and Misha forgave her. They became good friends again. Today's story is very similar. Many people were cruel to Joseph. His brothers had sold him into slavery. Potiphar sent him to prison. But God blessed him. In fact, Pharaoh put him in charge of the whole land of Egypt. Just as Joseph had predicted, according to what God had told him, Egypt had plenty of food for 7 years. Each year, Joseph carefully stored the extra grain. He knew that a terrible famine was coming. When the dry years came, Joseph had plenty of grain to sell to the starving people. One day, 10 men arrived from a foreign land to buy food. They bowed before Joseph, and as they stood up, he recognized his 10 older brothers. He had not seen them since they had sold him into slavery many years before. Joseph wanted to be sure they were different now, so he decided to test them. "You are spies," he said. "You have come to see how strong we are." "Oh, no, sir, we are not," his brothers replied. "We have come to buy food for our families. We are all the sons of one man. There were 12 of us. One is still at home and one is dead." But Joseph was not dead.
"Bring back your other brother to me, or I will know you are spies," Joseph commanded. "Your brother, Simeon, will stay here in prison while you are gone."
The worried brothers began their journey home. On the way back, one of them opened his sack and found money. "What is this?" he called to the others. "The money that I paid for this grain? It is in my sack. What will the governor do now?" When the brothers reached home, they told their father what had happened. "We must take Benjamin back with us," they pleaded. "It is the only way to prove that we are not spies, and we need to get Simeon back from Egypt."
"No, never," their father responded. "Joseph is lost to me. I cannot lose another son."
A few months later, the brothers went to their father again. "Our children will starve," they pleaded. "We have no more food. We must go back to Egypt." Their father didn't want to let Benjamin go, but he knew they needed food, and they needed it soon. He finally agreed, and the brothers went back to Egypt. When Joseph saw his younger brother Benjamin, he rushed to his private room to cry. But Joseph had one more test for his brothers. Were they still jealous? Would they be eager to get rid of Benjamin? "Fill their sacks," he told his steward, "and put my silver cup in Benjamin's sack." Soon the brothers were ready to go home. Joseph's steward did as Joseph said, and the brothers started on their way. A few miles from the palace, Joseph's steward stopped the caravan. He searched the men's sack and found Joseph's cup.
"Benjamin must return with me to the governor," he declared.
The brothers were worried. How could this be happening? What will the governor do? We can't leave Benjamin here. What will we tell our father?
"Your brother Benjamin must stay here," Joseph declared. "He will become my slave."
Joseph's brother Judah begged that Benjamin be released.
"I cannot go back to my father without Benjamin," he said. "Please,
Let me stay in his place. Joseph could hide no more. He broke into tears and told his brothers who he really was. He told them about Potiphar's house and the years in prison. He described Pharaoh's dreams and how he had come to be the second most powerful man in Egypt. It was not you who sent me here, he said, forgiving his brothers. It was God. God was with Joseph. God truly wants to be with us too. All you have to do is ask him. Today's story is called Together Again. The message is from Galatians chapter 6, verse 10. It says, "Let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers." Today's message is God helps me serve my family. When his parents were sick, Ethan stepped up and took care of his little brother so his parents could rest a while. Ethan served meals to his little brother and helped him clean up. Do you help to serve others in your family? Today's story is about what Joseph did for his family. After being away for many years, Father Jacob had returned to Canaan with his wives and 12 sons. Joseph was the second youngest and his father's favorite. Because of this, his older brothers hated him and decided to sell him to slave traders going to Egypt. In Egypt, Joseph had remained faithful to God even when bad things had happened to him. Eventually, God had helped him to become the governor. When a famine came on all the land, Jacob sent his 10 sons to Egypt for food. Joseph was in charge of the food, but Joseph's brothers did not know who he was. Yet Joseph knew them and finally made himself known. He told them that he had forgiven them for selling him into slavery. He promised to take care of the entire family, and now the brothers were on their way back to Canaan with the good news. What a grand trip it was! They had carts loaded with food. They had new clothes and money that Joseph had given them. They had many donkeys loaded with presents for their father. And they had Pharaoh's special invitation to come and live in Egypt. He had promised that their families would have food to eat during the rest of the famine. When they got home, their father, Jacob, could not believe the news. His favorite son, Joseph, was alive? Joseph was not dead as he believed all those years? "Are you sure?" he asked his sons over and over. "Are you sure Joseph is alive? And you say he is the governor of Egypt? Tell me again. Tell me again." Finally, Jacob and his family set out for Egypt. Jacob, his children, his in-laws, his grandchildren, everybody went. Some rode comfortably in the carts that Pharaoh had provided for them. Jacob's sons rode beside the carts on Pharaoh's plump donkeys. It was a long journey, but they had plenty of food for the trip. Jacob's heart sang the whole way. He was really, truly going to see his son Joseph once again. In Joseph's home, his servants brought him the good news. "Your family is almost here," they announced. "Hurry, get my chariot ready," Joseph ordered. He drove as fast as his horses could gallop to meet his father. When he got to where he was, Joseph ran to Jacob and hugged him. Together, they cried for joy. Soon after, Joseph took 5 of his brothers to the palace to meet Pharaoh.
"What is your occupation?" Pharaoh asked them.
"We are shepherds," the brothers answered.
Your brothers may live in Goshen, Pharaoh told Joseph. It is the best of my land, and I will also hire your brothers to take care of my cattle, if they wish. Joseph took his father to meet Pharaoh, too. Then Jacob, the great man of God, blessed Pharaoh, the mighty king of Egypt. After that, Jacob lived with his family in Egypt for 17 years. Then he died. He was 147 years old. Now Joseph's brothers began to worry. Now that their father was dead, what would Joseph do? Would he finally get even with them for the terrible thing they had done? They decided to send Joseph a message. Before our father died, he said he wanted you to forgive us for the evil thing we did to you. You meant to harm me, Joseph replied, but God meant it for good. He made it possible for me to help all of you. How has God made it possible for you to serve your family? You may never be an officer in your country's government. You may never have to save your family from starvation, but you are part of a family. What can you do now to help and show love to the people you live with? What can you do to serve your church family also?
Created and produced by Falvo Fowler, this podcast is read by Frenita Buddy Fullwood for Gracelink.net. Animation and artwork by Diogo Godoy. Audio is post-produced by Faith Toh at Studio Elpizo in Singapore. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. The audio engineer was Maurice Bailey.